boys and girls. How are you? How are you doing? How are you doing at home? I've been reading some of your emails. I've seen some of your drawings and pictures, and I'm so happy that you're doing your homework, that you're watching my videos. They're motivating you to do new things and fun things, I hope. So thank you. Thank you for doing them. Thank you for watching them and sending your emails to Asen, and then Asen forwards them to me. So I am so happy to hear from you, and hopefully next week we're going to do some video calls, so we're going to see each other, and I'm so excited about that. So today I'm going to do a video to teach you a new grammar rule, okay? So today we're going to learn something really, really, really easy that we've been using at school, but I just want to emphasize, you know, the difference or both ways of how you can say to have something, okay? This is the new grammar rule, if you want to call it grammatic rule. So when you have something, when you own something, when something is yours, you say I have, okay? For example, I have long brown hair. I have a Czech t-shirt. I have glasses, yeah. I can also say I have got long brown hair. I have got glasses. I have got a pink bracelet, yeah. So I can say exactly the same. I can say I have or I have got, okay? The same. It means exactly the same. I have got or I have. Now, the difference between have and have got, the main difference is that we use have when you're going to write something, when it's written, and you use have got when you're going to speak to somebody. So spoken English, you say have got. Written English, you say have. Okay? That is really the only main difference right now that we're gonna learn to, you know, learn how to distinguish have and have got. Now let's see at the pronouns. Do you remember the pronouns? I, you, he, she, it, we, you, they. Okay, so in some of them we're going to use have or have got, and in some of them we're going to use has or has got. Okay, let's review the pronouns. I have got. You have got. He, she, and it, these three, the third person singular, he, she, it has got. We have got. You have got. They have got. Okay, let's do it again. I have got. You have got. He has got. She has got. It has got. We have got. They have got. And you have got. Okay? Easy. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. We've done this at school. Now, remember, obviously have and have got, and has and has got. Written and spoken English. Let's see some examples. For example, remember the animals that we saw on the previous video? Yeah? Let's have a look, for example, at giraffe. Okay, I'm gonna put a picture of a giraffe right now. So let's look at this giraffe. So this giraffe has got brown patches. The giraffe has got brown patches. You can also say the giraffe has brown patches. Has or has got, okay? The giraffe has got a long neck, right? It has got a long neck. Yeah? Okay? Let's look at another example. For instance, a tiger. Let's look at the tiger. So the tiger has got black stripes. It has got black stripes. You can also say the tiger has black stripes or has got black stripes. The tiger has got whiskers. Do you remember what the whiskers are? You know, whiskers here. The tiger has got small ears. Small ears, okay? How about we look at an elephant? Yes, let's look at an elephant. The elephant has got big ears. Yes, you can also say the elephant has big ears. The elephant has got a long trunk or a long nose. You can also say the elephant has a long nose or a long trunk. The elephant has got big and big legs. Let's just say big legs. The elephant has got big legs or it has big legs. Yes? So, do you see the difference between saying, there's no real difference between just saying has and has got? Yes, it's exactly the same. Yeah, but remember, he, she, it, has, and I, you, we, and they have. So I have got, you have got, he has got, she has got, it has got. Okay? So what happens when we want to say, no, the negative form? The negative form, we use the word not. Yes, N-O-T, like it's written here, not. But to make it easier, to make it shorter, and so we don't have to write the whole thing, we can say haven't or hasn't. Has not is hasn't. Have not is haven't. So we have haven't for I, you, we, they. And we have hasn't for he, she, it. Okay? So this is the negative there, has not, hasn't. So when can we use this example? What if I ask, has the giraffe got short legs? No, she hasn't. Has she got long legs? Yes, she has. Let's think of another animal. Which one? Do you remember the orangutan? Remember the orangutan, that monkey that lives in the trees, the orange furry monkey? So, has the orangutan got short arms? No, it hasn't. Has it got long arms? Yes, it has. Okay? You see the difference? Yes, it has. No, it hasn't. If I was going to ask you, for example, if you ask me, have you got a motorcycle? I would say, no, I haven't. Okay. If I ask you, have you got a car? You could say, yes, I have, or no, I haven't. Okay. So it depends on what you want to answer. Yes, I have. No, I haven't. Yes. Yes, he has. No, he hasn't. Talking about the animals, yeah? I'm gonna give you another example about the animals. Remember which animals we had in the previous video? How about the zebra? Zebra, okay. The zebra. Has she got black and white stripes? Can you answer that? Has the zebra got black and white stripes? Yes, she has, or no, she hasn't? Yes, she has. Good. What other animal? Ah, the penguin. Okay. Has the penguin got wings? Remember, wings to fly. Has he got wings? Yes, he has, or no, he hasn't? Yes, he has. The flamingo. Flamingo. Has a flamingo got yellow feet? Yes, it has, or no, it hasn't. Do you remember the flamingo? Yeah? What color is a flamingo? Do you remember? pink. So the flamingo, has it got yellow feet? No, it hasn't got yellow feet. So no, it hasn't. Okay, so yes, it has for affirmative. No, it hasn't for negative. Yes, I have for affirmative. No, I haven't for negative. Okay, so now I'm going to send you some exercises for you to answer at home. You have to download these worksheets and you can answer them at home. They're super easy. Oh, one thing, I forgot the question. How do you ask a question with has or have? So the first rule to ask a question with these, they start with has or have. Has she got pink trousers? Yes, she has. No, she hasn't. Has he got a blue bike? Yes, it has. Yes, he has, or no, he hasn't. Okay, so we always start the question with has or with have. Okay? Okay, so in the question, you also have to add the word got. Has she got the pink trousers? Have you got a blue bike? Has the elephant got big ears? Yes, he has. No, he hasn't. Okay. Have you got? Has she got? Remember this word, got. Okay. So now let's see at the worksheet. They're super easy. And maybe if you want to, you can take a picture of them and you can send them to me so I can have a look at them. Okay. And anyway, next week, hopefully I will see you so we can practice all these things. Okay. See you soon, guys. Have a lovely week, lovely weekend, and I will see you very soon. Mwah!